Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer, and I'm a product manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. Today, I'm joined by Tzvia, who's a principal program manager on the Azure Data Explorer team, for an episode of Azure Data Explorer 101. In this series, you'll learn how to effectively use Azure Data Explorer. In each episode, we'll dive deep into a variety of topics to help you gain an understanding of the different capabilities of Azure Data Explorer. Without further ado, let me hand it over to Tzvia. Welcome.
Today, we're going to learn a little bit and talk about what is Azure Data Explorer, when to use it, and how to start with that. So let's start with the basic. Azure Data Explorer is a big data analytics cloud platform optimized for interactive ADX queries. A big data stands for mainly append data that stream in with minor adjustment of existing information. The 3V for big data with volume, velocity, and variety, high volume of data from gigabyte to terabytes and even petabytes and dozen petabytes of data per customers. Velocity of ingestion, you can ingest data from stream data all the time with high volume and small volume per your customer and your project needs. And variety of structure, with structured data, numbers, dates, GUID, semi-structure with HTML, XML, JSON, array of array. And of course, free text unstructured data is also fully supported, indexed, to have the most optimized performance on the query situation. Azure Data Explorer support highly perform analytics query operator from sort and filters to aggregation, join, and union between tables, databases, and even between clusters with calculated column, temporary views, and others. Everything on top of big data with very high performance. ADX is a cloud platform, Azure cloud platform, that is fully managed from the infrastructure with fully manual and automatic cluster adjustment up and down with the size for cost optimization and performance optimization. And also the database itself is also fully managed. All the partition indexes is managed by the service during ingestion time, and also the parallelism of queries users is everything managed by the database, and you can focus on the project and your business instead on the infrastructure. ADX is a database platform which was built and designed to support the most optimized performance for big data analytics with high performance requirements. With the KQL query, Kusto query language, it's promise that everyone in your organization will have a full access to the data and to make the optimization and the highest of efficiency of their performance based on the data availability. Of a sample of Power BI logs and traces. 41 terabytes of data that was compressed down to 3.6 terabytes of information. And if you ask why it's so important for me to know this compression ratio, I will answer. The database size will be defined per the compressed data size and not the original data size, which can help with the optimization of the query and also the optimization of the cost. And in this case, example, we just reduced the cost by 90% at the end of the month. So what have we learned from this? That Azure Data Explorer has a strong analytics engine to calculate any type of queries on your data. It was optimized to support different types of information with operational and development logs, with IoT events, with human logs, with customer services, chat, financial data, marketing events. ADX can support data size from few gigabytes of information to terabytes of data and even petabytes of information. It can support free text, structured and semi-structured information of JSON and other types. The latency from ingestion to query is a couple of seconds, and it can query up to billions of records in less than a second. It has low latency. It can support ingestion to query, including the historical data, in a couple of seconds. And it was built and designed to support human-friendly query language that enable everyone in your organization, the development, the ops, the marketing people, the program management, the financial people, the management, to access the data and to understand what is going on and to make adjustments easily and instantly per the activity of the information in your organization. You can go to MS Learn and see this data flow, answer five simple questions, and see whether Azure Data Explorer is the solution for your needs. And the third question now is how to start. You can go to our team blog in Tech Community, how to start with Azure Data Explorer, which provides a list of online free courses with MS Learn and Pluralsight that was built by our team, list of documentation and tutorials, and of course, we are highly engaged with our customers, so feel free to connect with us in LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, whatever is comfortable for you. We will Stack Overflow, of course. We will be there to answer your questions. Thank you for joining me today in my session about what Azure Data Explorer is, when to use it, and how to start with Tzvia Gitlin Troyna, Azure Data Explorer. Thanks.
Well, thanks, Tzvia. That wraps up our video for today. Tell us in the comments, do you use Kusto, Azure Data Explorer, any of these kinds of things? Let us know. I'd love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. More importantly, you can find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.